Today's review will focus on two small devices that will help you organize guaranteed power supply for your smart devices. DC/DC converters are electronic devices that convert direct current, DC, from one voltage level to another. One device is for stepping up the voltage, and the other is for stepping it down. All of them are very cheap, but they perform their functions perfectly. And with minimal soldering skills, you can connect a router to a power bank or a device with 5-volt USB power to a car battery. Let's take a closer look at these boards and consider several cases using them. Let's start with a board called a DC-DC step-up converter. Input 2 to 24 volts, output 5 to 28 volts, 2 amperes. Step-up converter MT3608, a reliable power supply for your projects. This compact and powerful module is ideal for converting low voltage to higher voltage, providing stable power to your electronic devices. With a wide input voltage range, 2 to 24 volts, and adjustable output, 5 to 28 volts, the MT3608 can be easily adapted to various needs. High efficiency and the ability to withstand current up to 2 amperes make it a universal solution for DIY projects, powering microcontrollers and other electronic devices. The device is extremely simple and reliable. We connect the input voltage to the VIN contacts, use a thin screwdriver to adjust the resistor, and get the voltage you need on the out contacts. The multi-turn resistor has a resistance of 100 ohm. The minimum input voltage is 2 volts, but 3.5 to 4 volts are better. As you can see, with a voltage of 3.5 volts, we get 11.5 volts at the output. The maximum input voltage is 24 volts. In this case, the output will be a maximum of 28 volts. The maximum current is 2 amperes, and it is enough for most smart home devices, routers, and other equipment. Now I set the input to 5 volts, at the output we get 27.8 volts. 28 volts. The idle current according to the instructions is only 6 milliamps, which is very good for organizing a backup power supply. Let's check what this board can be useful for. Here is a simple example. The router has a 12-volt power supply. Ideally, you need to buy a separate 12-volt battery for it and install a step-down DC-DC converter. But we only have a power bank, which has 5 volts at the output. We connect the board to the USB connector of our power bank. Now, with a thin screwdriver, we begin to rotate the trimmer screw on the resistor. Here, at the output, we can set 9 volts. For example, we connect a local network switch. In this case, we can immediately put the power bank on charge, and if the electricity goes out, the switch will continue to work. Or take a Wi-Fi router for example, they often have a 12-volt power supply and a current consumption of up to 1 ampere. We increase the voltage to 12 volts. We connect the router, as we can see, it started working. Also an option for organizing the uninterrupted operation of your network equipment or other smart home devices. The second type of DC-DC converter is a step-down converter on the LM2596S microcircuit from April 5, 40 volts to 3 to 35 volts, 2 amperes. This compact and powerful module is ideal for converting high voltage to lower voltage, providing stable power to your electronic devices. Thanks to a wide range of input voltage, 4.5 to 40 volts, and an adjustable output, 3 to 35 volts, LM2596S easily adapts to different voltage needs. This board is visually similar to the previous one. But now its task is to lower the voltage. We connect the incoming voltage to the IN contacts, and we get a reduced voltage on the out contacts. The minimum possible difference between the input and output voltage is 1.5 volts. The minimum is 3.5 volts at the input and 3 volts at the output. That is, when connecting 5 volts, the output will be a maximum of 4.5 volts. Output we get 35 or lower. For example, 32 volts, at the output 31.3 volts. To adjust the output voltage, use a screwdriver to turn the screw of the trimmer resistor. The maximum current is 2 amperes, if you use a cooling radiator, the current is 3 amperes. Consumption without load, 6 milliamperes, there is also short circuit protection. Now let's consider the option when we already have a battery, for example 12.4 volts. and I need to connect to it a part of the smart home that uses 5 volts. We connect 12.4 volts to the IN contacts, do not confuse the polarity, otherwise the board will simply burn out. We set the required voltage, 5 volts, with a trimmer resistor. As you can see, the smart home gateway has started up and is working without problems. Let's raise the voltage to 24 volts, also adjust and lower it to 5 volts. It will be convenient in trucks. As you can see, the smart home gateway has started up and is working without problems. Moreover, regardless of whether we increase or decrease the voltage to 5.5, the output will be 5 volts. Or, if necessary, connect a camera with a voltage of 5 volts through a 12-volt power supply. Due to its compact size, it can be easily packed in heat shrink or even in the case of the required device. Here are two small boards, but which can significantly save both time on searching for a burnt-out power adapter, especially if it is not popular. And turn your smart home into a virtually energy-independent one using a power bank or a battery with a charger. The only thing I do not recommend is connecting more than one device or a device that requires more than 2 amperes of current to one board, since the microcircuits can noticeably heat up. But for those devices that you saw in the review, a router, a smart home gateway and a switch, there will be no problems. You will find all links to the products in the description under the video. There is also a link to a group in Telegram, where you will find not only new products on the smart home system, but also coupons, promotions and other communication, and answers to questions. There is also a link to the Smart Home Forum, where all topics are divided into sections for more convenient communication and information search. Please do not forget to like if you liked the video, and subscribe to the channel so as not to miss other interesting videos about smart and not very home systems. All the best to everyone, peaceful skies and goodness. Bye bye.